ओम गणानां त्वा गणपतिं हवामहे कविं कवीनां उपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पत आनश्रुण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात्परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम डियर फ्रेंड्स, इन द लास्ट क्लास वी कंप्लीटेड द 48th श्लोक। दिस श्लोक, इन दट श्लोक वी सॉ द बिग आर्ग्युमेंट, द बिग डिबेट बिटवीन शंकराचार्य, दट इज वेदांती ऑन वन हैंड एंड द अदर पीपल, दट इज दोस हू से दट कर्म कैनॉट बी गिवन अप। The argument of Purvapakshis, that is whether it is Sankhya or whether it is Mimamsaka, they are Tarkika also, Vaisheshika and Tarkika, they are called Samana Tantras. So those people, their argument is that karma cannot be given up. They are basically dualists. Karma cannot be given up, karma has to be there. So that is what their contention. Then ultimately we saw that the Siddhanti is established, the view that karma can be given up by a jnani. Karma cannot be given up by an ajnani. So that is what we have seen. So karma cannot be given up by an ajnani. That also we have seen. There we have also seen one stage called karma yoga. Karma yoga is again, is it done by a jnani or ajnani? No. Karma you can say by stuti you can say jnani. He is not really a jnani. He is a seeker. So jnani means one who has realized he has no sense of that I notion has gone. So once that I notion has gone, there is no question of karma yoga. So karma yoga is done technically by an ajnani. Though we may by way of stuti you can say he is better than us or something like that, you are a jnani, something like that you can say, but then karma yoga is also done by an ajnani only. So karma yoga produces jnana nishtha yogyata lakshana siddhi. So that is what we saw in that sloka, swakarmana tamabhyarchya siddhim vindati manavaha. There we saw that is 46th sloka, swakarmana tamabhyarchya siddhim vindati manavaha. There what type of siddhi is that? Jnana nishtha yogyata lakshanam siddhim vindati prapnoti. That's what we saw. So jnana nishtha yogyata, he becomes fit to sit in a higher class. There, having taken his seat there in that higher class, he has to again go through this process of shravana manana nididhyasana. Then only he will get that jnana nishtha. So that is the overall hierarchy, isn't it? So now we are going to see about that. What is that karmaja siddhi? What is that jnana nishtha yogyata lakshana siddhi leading to the real siddhi? There are two levels of siddhi. One is yogyata. The other is the real siddhi. Jnana nishtha yogyata lakshana siddhi, jnana nishtha siddhi. So these two things, that word yogyata will go, he will become full-fledged jnani. So that is it. Then did we read the shloka in the last line?
No.
No. Let us read the line. Avatarika also. Yacha karmaja siddhihi ukta.
Yacha karmaja siddhihi ukta.
Jnana nishtha yogyata lakshana. तस्या फलभूता नैष्कर्म्य सिद्धिः ज्ञान निष्ठा लक्षणा च वक्तव्य इति श्लोकः आरभ्यते। ओके, दिस कर्मज सिद्धिः, सो दिस सिद्धि ही हैज वेरी ब्यूटिफुली सेड, इट इज कर्मज सिद्धि, सिद्धि अराइजिंग आउट ऑफ कर्म, Siddhi born out of karma. What sort of siddhi can be born out of karma? It will be a limited siddhi only. It is no doubt better than karma phala, other karma phala like swargam etc. It is better than that sort of phalam, but then this is also limited. You are attaining chitta siddhi. Having attained chitta siddhi, you have to go to a higher level. So that is the point. So yacha karmaja siddhihi bhukta, he is himself is explaining jnana nishtha yogyata lakshana, that which can be called this jnana nishtha yogyata, the eligibility to get into, sit in that higher class called jnana nishtha. Tasyaha phalabhuta, So what is the result of that particular class? If you continue in that class, what is it you are going to get? Naishkarmiya Siddhi. That is the higher Siddhi. This is one lower Siddhi, and that is what is called a higher Siddhi, Naishkarmiya Siddhim. Tasyaha Phalabhuta. Phalam is result. What is the result or what is the say, gain you get there? That is Naishkarmiya Siddhi. Naishkarmiya Siddhi, what is that? Jnana Nishtha Lakshana. You are stationed, Nishtha. Nishchayena Avasthanam. You are firmly stationed in that Jnana position. So you are in that awareness of self. You are in that awareness of self as not different from Brahman. And once you are aware that you are not different from Brahman, there is no question of you are having any activity. So that sort of actionlessness is achieved. Naishkarmyam. Karma is action. Nirgata karma is nishkarma. Nishkarma. Nirgata karma yasmat. Of course, Shankaracharya is going to give that whole Vigrahavakya also for that Sunday, for that Samasa. He is going to give a Vigrahavakya. I will just briefly explain. So the state where all the karmas have disappeared. So that person is called Nishkarma. A person from whom all karmas have disappeared is called Nishkarma. And that state is called Naishkarmyam. So that Naishkarmya Siddhi. Naishkarmyam cha tat Siddhishya. That is that Nishkarma, that Naishkarmyam itself is the Siddhi. So that is one way of saying that Naishkarmyam itself is Siddhi. Or Shankaracharya is also saying Nishkarmatvasya va Siddhihi. That is attainment of that Nishkarmatvasya Siddhi. That is attainment of that actionlessness. So that way, anyway, Naishkarmya Siddhi, you can interpret it as Naishkarmyam itself is Siddhi. Or attainment of that Naishkarmyam. In both ways, whether it is Karmadharaya Samasa or Tatpurusha Samasa, it doesn't matter. The meaning is that the actions have disappeared from that gentleman. Maybe he has totally renounced all actions like a full-fledged sannyasi, or maybe like a King Janaka, he may be performing actions, but still he is Nishkarma. He is Nishkarma means actions do not touch him. So of course Shankaracharya has not very expressly he has not stated that, but that is the general structure in which we have to imagine, we have to visualize that situation. Otherwise we can't explain Jnani Karma, we can't explain karma of Rajarshi. So that is the point. So here let us read the shloka. Asakta buddhis sarvatra.
Asakta buddhis sarvatra.
Jitatma vigatas pruhaha.
Jitatma vigatas pruhaha.
Naishkarmya siddhim paramam.
Naishkarmya siddhim paramam.
Sanyasena adhigachati.
Sanyasena adhigachati.
Okay. Asakta buddhihi jitatma vigatasprahaha. So there are three qualifications for this gentleman. Asakta buddhihi. One whose mind is not attached to things. Asaktam, na saktam, sangarahitam. It is not attached to things. So he has gone out of that stage. Asakta buddhihi. Where sarvatra, in all things. Okay, it is not as though you have given up some unnecessary things and you are still having great love, fondness for your wife, children, etc., etc., your property, etc. Even here. There are all types of traps you have avoided. The wife and wife, children, whatever it is. All those things, all those great points of attachment you have dismissed. So that is that asakta buddhi sarvatra. Sarvatra means not only, okay, I have given up some kakarakaya and not like that. You have also given up various things which you are fond of. So that is it. Sakta buddhi sarvatra, then jita atma. One who has controlled his self, jitaha atma yena sa jita atma. Then vigata spruha yasmat sa vigata spruha. Where this spruha means liking. Spruha is love, fondness, liking. So that is vigata, vigataha. That is, it has gone, it has disappeared. Even that liking has disappeared. Liking is one level and fondness, attachment is another level. After you attain it, there is an attachment and liking before you get it. So that sort of thing, some difference. So that person, Naishkarmya Siddhim Paramam Adhigachati. Paramam Naishkarmya Siddhim. Paramam is the supreme, that supreme Naishkarmya Siddhi, that actionlessness, that state of actionlessness. Naishkarmya Siddhim Paramam Adhigachati means attains. How? Sanyasena. Sanyasena means by renouncing actions. But Shankaracharya, luckily he has said, Samyak Darshanena, Sanyasena, he has said, Shankaracharya is also saying, Samyak Darshanena, that is by proper understanding, which means Shankaracharya is not ruling out a Jnani, Rajarshi. A Rajarshi like Kuchki Janaka or some other Lord Rama or even Arjuna now who is going to see, Krishna himself, Arjuna we can't say he is on the level of Rajarshi, but Krishna definitely. So like that, Shankaracharya also is giving the same interpretation. Sanyasena means Samyak Darshanena, that is by proper understanding, by the right awareness. Right awareness means knowledge of the union of, knowledge of the oneness of self and the Brahman. So that is that Samyak Darshanam. By that, Naishkarmya Nishtham, Naishkarmya Siddhim Adhigachyati, one attains that Naishkarmyam, actionlessness. So that is it. Let us read the Bhashyam. Asakta buddhi riti. Asakta sangarahita buddhi hi antahkaranam yasya.
Saha asakta buddhi hi. Sarvatra.
Putra dharadishu asakti nimitteshu. Jitatma jitaha vashikrutaha atma antahkaranam yasya sa jitatma. Okay, we'll stop here. Asakta buddhi. Asakta means sangarahita, devoid of attachment. Sangarahita. Buddhi hi antahkaranam. Antahkaranam means that internal organ, that is what we call manas. Antahkaranam, of course, there is four levels. Buddhi, manasu, buddhi, antahkarana and chitta, four levels. So in this, we are not making a great differentiation here. Asakta buddhihi, asaktam antahkaranam. So yesya saha asakta buddhihi. Then sarvatra, he is, Shankaracharya is going to see, he is also saying the same thing. Putra dharadishu, putra, sons, or children, let us say, dharadishu, bharya, wife, dharaha, wife in Sanskrit, you see, the word dharaha is a nitya bahuvachanam. Wife, you can't say dharaha means wives. There is a beautiful word called Dharaha. So that means you are giving a great respect to that lady, addressing her in that Bahuvachana, plural. Dharaha is a Nitya Bahuvachana. So Putra Dharadishu. Dharadishu means you should not think that he is having too many wives, children and wife. Adishu means in such close things. So even in that close things, Asakti Nimitteshu, these are the causes for attachment. These are all the, these are the biggest causes of attachment. So even in that situation, or even in the case of these people, then jitaatma, jitaha vashikurtaha atma, that is, his antahkarana is under his control. He has got atma sanyama. In other words, that chapter 6, what we have seen as atma sanyama, he is a gentleman who has achieved that atma sanyama. Then sa jitaatma, vigata spruhaha, yeah, we have to read. Vigata spruha trushna
deha jivita bhogeshu yasmat sa vigata spruha
ya evam bhutah atmagnyah sa naishkarmya siddhim निर्गतानि कर्माणि यस्मात्
तस्य भावः नैष्कर्म्यम्
नैष्कर्म्यम् च तत् सिद्धिश्च सा नैष्कर्म्य सिद्धिः निष्क्रियात्मस्वरूपावस्थानलक्षणस्य सिद्धिः निष्पत्तिः ताम् नैष्कर्म्यसिद्धिम् We'll stop here because the sentence is still going away. Vigata spruha. Vigata means it has fallen off. Vigata, because of your maturity of mind, slowly all your childhood attractions, they disappear. Just as you don't play with toys now, similarly after you attain some maturity, we dismiss various things. we dismiss all our silly friends who waste our time. So all these things, all these are all things, like our toys only. In our childhood we play with toys, as we grow old we slowly give up toys, and then we'll acquire some other type of friends. And once you mature, you will also realize that this is something useless, the fellow is wasting my time. So slowly you try to avoid so many things. So like that, gradually as you mature, you discard so many things. So here, vigata, sprushna, trushna, deha, jivita, bhogeshu. Whether it is in the body, or whether it is in jivitam, or whether it is in bhoga. Bhoga is enjoyment. Bhuja dhatu. Bhuja is to enjoy, to experience. All those things. Yasmat sa vigata spruhaha. One from whom all these things have dropped off. You have not deliberately rejected, they get automatically dropped off. People who want to come and waste your time. Maybe 10 years ago you would have entertained them, but now you don't feel like entertaining them. So it happens to us. We see every day such droppings. dropping, of course, I don't know whether we can call it a dropping or droppage. Droppages. Vigata spruha. Ya evam bhutaha atmagnyaha. The person who is of this nature, evam bhutaha means one who is of this type. That is, who is he? Atmagnya. One who knows, one who has realized atma. Then saha, that man, naishkarmya siddhim apnoti. Naishkarmya siddhi he attains. And what is this naishkarmya siddhi? Shankaracharya is giving this vigraha vakyam. You know, for every samasa, that is what is called a vigraha vakyam. You explain that, say, samasa, that is called vigraha vakya. Nirgatani karmani yasmat. One from whom all these karmas have disappeared, have gone away. Nirgatani. Gata. Ganave, gatani, have gone away. Nirgatani, nishayana gatani, sarvani. So, karmani, sarvani, yasmat. From one from whom all the actions have disappeared. Why, how have they disappeared? Nishkriya brahmatma sambodhat. That is because of the understanding. Sambodha means sam plus bodha, samyak bodha. Bodha means understanding, avagahana. So, nishkriya brahmatma sambodhat. So he has realized that this Atma is the same as Brahman, which it is again Nishkriyam. Nishkriya, Brahma, Atma. So there are three words there. So Atma is something, is the same as Brahma, which is again Nishkriyam. Something which is actionless. It is not connected with anything. So with that understanding, because of that understanding, all these karmas have disappeared from him. Sambodha, sa Nishkarma. So such person is Nishkarma. Nirgatani karmani yasmat sa nishkarma. So that is the thing. Tasya bhavaha naishkarmyam. That state, your bhavartha, if you take the bhavartha, that is called naishkarmyam. That state of actionlessness. So that is it. Then again, naishkarmyam cha tat siddhischa. He is again explaining that naishkarmya siddhi. Naishkarmyam he has explained. Now naishkarmya siddhi. Naishkarmyam cha tat siddhischa. That same whatever is naishkarmyam is the same as siddhi. That itself is the attainment. So that is one way. That is called karmadharaya samasa. Then or you can say tatpurusha samasa. Nishkarmatvasya va siddhihi. That is attainment of that nishkarmatvasya shashti. Shashti tatpurusha samasa. That is nishkarmatvasya va siddhihi. You can say like that also. It doesn't matter much in whatever way you explain the samasa. The meaning is same, that is you have attained that state of actionlessness because of knowledge you have attained actionlessness. Then nishkriya atmaswarupa avasthana lakshanasya siddhihi. Attainment of that particular status where nishkriya atmaswarupa avasthana, that is you are in your state of that atmaswarupa, in your own self. What is that self? That nishkriya, where that is untouched by any type of activity, untouched by any type of action. In fact, this Naishkarmya Siddhi is one book written by, you must be knowing that book, Sureshwaracharya. Sureshwaracharya, who is one of the students of Shankaracharya. There are four well-known students of Shankaracharya. For Shankaracharya might have had hundreds of students, we do not know. But four among them are very, very well-known. Padmapada, Totaka, Sureshwara and another gentleman. So these four. So, out of them, this Sureshwaracharya is said to be, in Purvashrama he is called Mandana Mishra, the same gentleman with whom Shankaracharya had a debate. Mandana Mishra, the great logician and great Mimamsaka, with him he had a debate. And then after he was defeated in the debate, he became his disciple, and then he became one staunch. So in fact, Sureshwaracharya is said to be the first Pithadipati of Sringeri Pitha. The first Pithadipati of Sringeri Pitham is our Sureshwaracharya Mandana Mishra, coming somewhere from Sevaranasi, or we do not know from where. So that is the history. But anyway, he has written a book called Naishkarmya Siddhi. It seems it is said that he just composed it just overnight. So anyway, so Naishkarmya Siddhi, Siddhihi, Nishpattihi. Nishpatti means that is the result, that is what is Nishpadyam, that is what has resulted. That is the culmination, Nishpatti, that is Nishpatti, we use it in another sense. In Telugu, we use it in the sense of ratio. It is not ratio, it is Nishpadyam, whatever has come, whatever is the culmination, that is what is Nishpatti. So that sort of Naishkarmya Siddhim. Now let us read
Paramam Prakrushtam
Karmaja Siddhi Vilakshanam Sadyomukti Avasthana Rupam Sanyasena Samyak Darshanena Tatpurvakena Va Sarvakarma Sanyasena
Adhigachati Prapnoti.
So Parama, what is that Parama? Means Prakrushta. Compared with what? Compared with that earlier Siddhi, Karmaja Siddhi. Karmaja Siddhi is Jnana Nishtha Yogyata. So you have become eligible to sit in that MA. And after you have become eligible, you have also passed that MA and you have crossed, let us say you have also attained a PhD, something like that. So that is that Jnana Nishtha. That is that, say what is that, Naishkarmya Siddhi. So, Paramam Prakrushtam, Karmaja Siddhi Vilakshanam. It is something which is distinct from that Karmaja Siddhi. Vilakshanam is something which is distinct. Karmaja Siddhi Vilakshana. That is something which is distinct from that Karmaja Siddhi. What is that Karmaja Siddhi? Karmaja Siddhi is Yogyata only. It is something which is beyond that Yogyata. You have attained, gone beyond that Yogyata and you have attained the real Siddhi. So, that is the point. Then what is that? Sadyomukti avasthana rupam. We have also seen this word sadyomukti, kramamukti and sadyomukti. Kramamukti is that process of you do some karmas and all that. This you go to Brahmaloka, and in that Brahmaloka you gain, along with that Brahma you attain that mukti. That is what? Kramamukti. Then sadyomukti is jivan mukti, is also otherwise called jivan mukti. In this life itself, you attain this mukti, you attain that understanding. Understanding liberates you from all types of bondages. Understanding liberates you from all types of fears and all types of limitations. So that is the point. Understanding liberates us from all types of limitations. You don't depend on anybody, you are free, you are bold, you just don't bother for anything. So that is the type of abhayam. Abhayam, that is the state of abhaya, which we get. That is, then sanyasena, say, then samyak darshanena. This is again we saw. Then he also gives an choice. There can be another way of also saying tat purvakena va sarvakarma sanyasena. He is including both the people. He is including a rajarshi and also a regular sanyasi. A total sarvakarma sanyasi is also sanyasi. A rajarshi who has done Sarvakarmani Manasa Sanyasya, one who has renounced them by mind, within his Antahkarana. So he is also a sannyasi. So he is including both these people. Samyak Darshanena, number 2, Tatpurva Kenava Sarvakarma Sanyasena. So this sort of Samyak Darshana, which is preceded by Samyak Darshana preceding that Karma Sanyasa. Or rather, Sarvakarma Sanyasa preceded by Samyak Darshana. Samyak Darshana is first, after that Kanyasarma Karma Sanyasa. So Sarva Karma Sanyasa he does basing on his awareness, basing on his full knowledge. So both ways it is called, what is this, Naishkarmya Siddhi. So Adhigachati Prapnoti. Then Tathacha Uktam Sarva Karmani Manasa Sanyasya Naiva Kurvan Nakarayan Aste Iti. Okay, this is what the earlier shlokas, Sarvakarmani Manasa Sanyasyaste Sukham Vashi, although that we have seen, by mentally renouncing all actions, he is happy, he is renounced and all that. Then Naiva Kurvan Nakarayan, he is not doing anything, he is not making others do. So that is Nakarayan, so we have seen that. Then next, पूर्वोक्तेन स्वकर्मानुष्ठानेन ईश्वराभ्यर्चन रूपेण जनितां प्रागुक्तलक्षणां सिद्धिं प्राप्तस्य उत्पन्नात्मविवेकज्ञानस्य केवलात्मज्ञाननिष्ठारूपा नैष्कर्म्यलक्षणा सिद्धिः येन क्रमेण भवति तद्वक्तव्यमित्याह। सो नेक्स्ट द कनेक्शन इज बाय मेयर ज्ञाननिष्ठा योग्यता यू आर नॉट गोइंग टू अटेन से ज्ञाननिष्ठा। योग्यता इज एलिजिबिलिटी टू सिट इन दट क्लास बट यू शुड ऑल्सो स्टडी फॉर टू इयर्स एंड देन गेट पास दट। सो दट इज इट। By mere jnana nishtha yogyata one doesn't get that, but again you have to go through some other process. So that is it. Purvoktena, that is earlier said, whatever earlier was said, swakarmanatam abhyarcha, swakarmanushthanena, swakarmanushthana, there again we have seen that it was done with Ishwararpana buddhi, that is karma yoga, swakarmanushthanena, Ishwarabhyarchana rupena, that is work is worship by doing that siddhi, by doing that karma. स्वसहजं कर्म कौंतेय सदोषमपि न त्यजेत एंड ऑल्सो स्वभाव प्रभवैर्गुणैः दट इज ऑल दीस कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स विच आर बॉर्न आउट ऑफ स्वभाव। सो दट इज जस्ट दट इज युवर नेचर। सो स्वभाव सत्व रजस्तमो गुणस् सो ऑल दट थिंग ईश्वरार्चन रूपेण जनितां प्रागुक्तलक्षणां सिद्धिं प्रागुक्तलक्षणा सिद्धिः दट इज सिद्धि द टाइप ऑफ सिद्धि विच वाज टोल्ड अर्लियर। What is that siddhi? Yogyata siddhi. Chitta shuddhi. In other words, simply you can write down as chitta shuddhi. You can write it as chitta shuddhi. Chitta shuddhi lakshanam. Instead of pragupta lakshanam siddhi means chitta shuddhi lakshanam. Praptasya. That is for the one who has attained that chitta shuddhi. Utpannatma viveka jnanasya. From that, then from there he attains that jnananishtha. He attains utpanna atma jnana, atma viveka jnanasya. केवल आत्मज्ञाननिष्ठा रूपा नैष्कर्म्य सिद्धि देन केवल आत्मज्ञाननिष्ठा दट इज ही हैज गॉन टू द हायर लेवल ऑफ केवल आत्मज्ञाननिष्ठा। ही हैज कम टू दट लेवल ऑफ केवल। केवल मीन्स द ओनली वन आत्मा। आत्मा इज ओनली वन। सो दट सॉर्ट ऑफ निष्ठा हाउ ही इज एबल टू अटेन एंड इन वाट मैनर एंड इन वाट ऑर्डर येन क्रमेण भवति इन वाट ऑर्डर इट हैपन्स। सो तद् वक्तव्यम दट हैज टू बी एक्सप्लेन्ड। सो फॉर दट अनदर श्लोक इज कमिंग। देन लेट अस रीड द श्लोक। सिद्धिं प्राप्तो यथा ब्रह्म तथाप्नोति निबोधमे समासेनैव कौन्तेय निष्ठा ज्ञानस्य या परा। सो या परा निष्ठा वर्तते ज्ञानस्य दट इज दट पर्टिकुलर निष्ठा दट सुप्रीम स्टेटस कॉल्ड परा निष्ठा। ज्ञानस्य परानिष्ठा ऑफ दट ज्ञान दट सुप्रीम ज्ञान निष्ठा समासेन निबोधमे। समासेन मीन्स ब्रीफली। आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू ब्रीफली बिकॉज अर्जुन हिमसेल्फ इज नॉट हैविंग मच टाइम। कृष्णा ऑल्सो इज नॉट हैविंग मच टाइम। देर आर एनिमी। देर इज एन एनिमी से आर्मी विच इज देर इन फ्रंट। सो ही हैज टू वेरी ब्रीफली पॉइंट आउट वेरी ब्रीफली रिकैपिचुलेट एंड मूव ऑन। सो दट इज वाई समासेन कौन्तेय ज्ञानस्य या परानिष्ठः तत् निबोध मे। मे मीन्स फ्रॉम माय वर्ड्स। निबोध मीन्स यू नो अबाउट नो फ्रॉम माय वर्ड्स। निबोध मे वाट सिद्धिं प्राप्तः यथा ब्रह्म तथा प्नोति देन सिद्धिं प्राप्तः दिस सॉर्ट ऑफ सिद्धि द पर्सन हू हैज गॉट दिस ज्ञाननिष्ठा योग्यता लक्षणा सिद्धि। सो वी आर नाउ इनिशियली वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस सिद्धि इज सिद्धि लिटरली मीन्स अटैनमेंट बट इन दिस कॉन्टेक्स्ट सिद्धि इज योग्यता। चित्तशुद्ध लक्षण चित्तशुद्धि लक्षण सिद्धि। सिद्धिं प्राप्तः द वन हू हैज अटेन्ड दट इनिशियल लेवल फर्स्ट लेवल सिद्धि यथा ब्रह्म तथा आप्नोति। यथा ब्रह्म आप्नोति हाउ इन वाट मैनर ही अटेन्स दट हायर लेवल सिद्धि तथा दट निबोध मे यू प्लीज नो फ्रॉम मी समासेन इन ब्रीफ ज्ञानस्य दत् परानिष्ठा। ओके लेट अस रीड दिस श्लोक भाष्यम। सिद्धिं प्राप्तः स्वकर्मणा ईश्वरं समभ्यर्च्य तत्प्रसादजां कायेन्द्रियाणां
ज्ञाननिष्ठा
योग्यतालक्षणां सिद्धिं प्राप्तः सिद्धिं प्राप्तः इति तदनुवादः उत्तरार्थः ओके सो सिद्धिं प्राप्तः व्हाट टाइप ऑफ सिद्धि ही इज एक्सप्लेनिंग स्वकर्मण ईश्वरं समभ्यर्ष्य हैविंग वर्शिप्ड शिवा सॉरी ईश्वर हैविंग वर्शिप्ड ईश्वर मीन्स ईश्वर अगेन वी आर नॉट रेफरिंग टू लॉर्ड शिवा हू इज हस्बैंड ऑफ पार्वती वी आर रेफरिंग टू दट मायावच्छिन्नम चैतन्यम ईश्वर द कॉस्मिक माइंड द कॉस्मिक द रूलर सो हैविंग वर्शिप्ड हाउ स्वकर्मण बै परफॉर्मिंग वन ओन कर्म बै परफॉर्मिंग वन ओन स्वभाव विहित कर्म सो दट सॉर्ट ऑफ अर्चना हैविंग डन एंड तत् प्रसादात बै हिज ग्रेस प्रसाद मीन्स बै हिज ग्रेस भगवत प्रसादात हियर भगवान इज नॉट सुप्रीम ब्रह्म दट ईश्वर तत् प्रसादात वट इज ही अटेनिंग कायेन्द्रियाणां काय प्लस इंद्रिय काय इज बॉडी इंद्रिय सेंसेस ऑफ दीज ऑल दीज थिंग्स ज्ञाननिष्ठा योग्यता लक्षणां सिद्धिं सो ही हैज अटेंड हिज ज्ञाननिष्ठा योग्यता फॉर हिज बॉडी एंड इंद्रियस इन व्हाट मैनर इट मीन्स दट ही हैज केप्ट हिज बॉडी अंडर कंट्रोल शम दम ही हैज अटेंड दिस दम बाह्येन्द्रिय निग्रह दट इज द होल बॉडी अंतरिंद्रिय निग्रह दट इज इंद्रिय निग्रह दट इज शम सो ही हैज अटेंड ऑल दिस दट सॉर्ट ऑफ सिद्धिं प्राप्तः दट मीन्स ही हैज अटेंड दट चित्तशुद्धि सिद्धिं प्राप्तः इति तद अनुवादः उत्तरार्थ अनुवाद मीन्स रेपिटेशन अनुवाद इज नॉट ट्रांसलेशन अनुवाद इन तेलुगु वी मिसयूज द वर्ड अनुवाद मीन्स रेपिटेशन सो वै ही इज सेयिंग दट अगेन सिद्धिं प्राप्तः इन ऑर्डर टू कनेक्ट टू वाट ही इज गोइंग टू से लेटर तद उत्तरार्थः उत्तरार्थः मीन्स उत्तर मीन्स लेटर उत्तरार्थः मीन्स वाट ही इज गोइंग टू से लेटर It is basically Siddhim Praptaha is being told in order to connect to what he is being told, what he is going to say later. And what is it that he is going to say later? We are going to see. Kim tad uttaram? Kim tad uttaram means what is that he is going to say? So that is it. Just connecting, connection he is explaining, that's all. Kim tad uttaram yadarthaha anuvada iti anuvadaha? That means for what say, for whose sake, or for say, for in order to explain what, in order to explain what, you see this anuvada, this repetition, what for is this anuvada? So that is it. Iti uchyate, that is being told.
Yatha yena prakarena
jnananishtha rupena brahma paramatmanam प्राप्नोति तथा तं प्रकारं ज्ञाननिष्ठा प्राप्तिक्रमं मे मम वचनात् निबोधा त्वं निश्चयेन अवधारय इत्येतत् ओके यथा इन् वाट् मैनर् यथा मीन्स् इन् वाट् मैनर् यथा येन प्रकारेण इन् वाट् मैनर् ज्ञाननिष्ठा रूपेण एंड व्हाट इज दैट दट ज्ञाननिष्ठा ही इज अटेनिंग दट ज्ञाननिष्ठा फ्रॉम ए लोअर लेवल ही इज अटेनिंग दट हायर लेवल व्हाट इज दट ज्ञाननिष्ठा ब्रह्म परमात्मानम ब्रह्म दट सुप्रीम सेल्फ दट थिंग प्राप्नोति मीन्स अटेन्स तथा तम प्रकारम दट पर्टिकुलर प्रकारम दट पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस दट पर्टिकुलर आर्डर ऐ एम गोइंग टू से ज्ञाननिष्ठा प्राप्ति क्रमम दट आर्डर इन विच यू आर गोइंग टू गेट दट ज्ञाननिष्ठा मे मम वचनात् फ्रॉम माय वर्ड्स निबोध यू प्लीज नो त्वं निश्चयेन अवधारय यू प्लीज वेरी केयरफुली लिसन अवधारय मीन्स अंडरस्टैंड अवधारय अवधारणम देन किम विस्तरेण इज इट इन अ वेरी डिटेल्ड वे दट इज इट किम विस्तरेण मीन्स इज इट इन अ वेरी एलैबोरेट डिटेल्ड मैनर नो न इत्याह समासेनैव संक्षेपेणैव Of course, there is no reason given why he this samasena. We can only presume that after all there is an enemy in front and then Arjuna also is not very right now qualified to listen to all this. Where the person is qualified and where the situation is appropriate, Krishna is going to tell in a more elaborate way. Like he does the same thing in Anugita. After at the end of the war, somewhere in Ashwamedha Parva or somewhere, there is a very elaborate passage called Anugita, where again Arjuna asks, Arjuna and Krishna, they are just going for some evening walk or some stroll. So there Arjuna asks, oh, You have at that time you had told me some very fantastic message you had given to me. I have forgotten. Can you kindly recall and tell? So then Krishna again very elaborately tells so many things. So that is Anugita. There in that context, he tells in a more elaborate way. So like that. So samasenaiva samkshepena. Samasam is samkshepa, in brief. हे कौन्तेय यथा ब्रह्म प्राप्नोति तथा निबोध इति ओके इन व्हाट मैनर यू कैन अटेन ब्रह्म दैट यू अंडरस्टैंड देन अनेन या प्रतिज्ञाता ब्रह्म प्राप्ति ही
अनेन या प्रतिज्ञाता ब्रह्म प्राप्ति
ताम इदंतया दर्शयितुम आह
ताम इदंतया दर्शयितुम आह
निष्ठा ज्ञानस्य या परा इति
निष्ठा ज्ञानस्य या परा इति
सो बाय सेइंग द वर्ड्स दिस निष्ठा ज्ञानस्य या परा दैट पर्टिकुलर सुप्रीम निष्ठा अबाउट विच आई हैव टू से सो ही इज सेइंग इदंतया मीन्स होल्डिंग ऑन द कॉलर एंड शोइंग होल्डिंग ऑन द कॉलर ऑफ ए पर्सन एंड शोइंग दिस इज इट So, idam means this. Idam taya darshayitum. In order to just hold it by the collar and say. Of course, I am saying collar, but in olden days, the collar was not there. They say shrunga grahikaya. Suppose there is some sort of bull or something like that. You hold it by the horn and then say, this is it. So, shrunga grahikaya. So, that is the usage. That is the idiomatic way in Sanskrit. The idiom is, Sanskrit idiom is, shrunga grahikaya darshayitum. You just, if you are demonstrating or if you are showing something in a very, very, say, very picture, very direct manner, shrunga grahikaya, that is, you hold it by the horn and then explain, yes, this is it. So, that is it. So, now, tam idam taya darshayitum. This is it. So, in order to say that, अनेन या प्रतिज्ञाता ब्रह्म प्राप्ति ही प्रतिज्ञाता मीन्स वट एवर हैज बीन टोल्ड वट एवर हैज बीन अश्योर्ड प्रतिज्ञा मीन्स ए स्टेटमेंट प्रतिज्ञातम मीन्स ए स्टेटमेंट वॉज मेड सम अश्योरेंस वॉज गिवन सो अनेन या प्रतिज्ञाता ब्रह्म प्राप्ति ही दिस ब्रह्म प्राप्ति विच वॉज अश्योर्ड दैट इदम तया दर्शयितुम इन ऑर्डर टू शो इट होल्डिंग इट बै द कॉलर ही इज सेइंग निष्ठा ज्ञानस्य या परा ही इज जस्ट होल्डिंग इट बै द कॉलर एंड सेइंग यस दिस इज वॉट आई वॉन्टेड टू शो सो दट इज इट देन निष्ठा पर्यवसानम परिसमाप्ति ही इत्येतत्
निष्ठा पर्यवसानम परिसमाप्ति ही इत्येतत्
सो व्हाट इज दट निष्ठा निष्ठा मीन्स दट इज द क्लाइमैक्स दट इज द फाइनल दट इज द कल्मिनेशन निष्ठा दट इज द पर्यवसानम दट इज द फाइनल कल्मिनेशन The consummation of knowledge, the culmination of all knowledge, that is it. Culmination, the consummation, that is the climax, ultimate, whatever you want to say. Pariyavasanam, parisamaptihi, that is the final stage, parisamaptihi tiyatat, of what? Kasya, of what?
Kasya.
Brahmajnanasya.
Brahmajnanasya.
Ya para parisamaptihi tadrushi.
Ya para parisamaptihi tadrushi.
So, jnanam has to result in some type of action, isn't it? Jnanam naturally has to result in some type of action. So this is a particular jnanam where it is resulting in some sort of actionlessness. So this particular jnanam, it is not like all other jnanams. If it is a Vishaya jnanam, suppose I know this pen. So I know that after my knowledge of this pen will enable me to write something, read, say, use it for something like that. So jnanam is producing some action in all cases. But here it is leading to actionlessness, naishkarmiyam. So because it is a totally different type of jnanam. So that is brahmajnanasya parisamaptihi. What is the parisamapti or what is the culmination? That is nishtha. That parisamaptihi, brahmajnanasya nishtha, that we are reaching. Yadrusham paramatma jnanam. What type of paramatma jnanam? Kidrusham atma jnanam. What type of Atma Jnana is that? Yadrushaha Atma is the reply for Kidrusham Atma Jnana. Kidrusham Atma Jnana means of what type is that Atma Jnana? Yadrushaha Atma. Just as Atma is, in whatever manner Atma is there, the knowledge is of that type. In whatever manner Atma is there, Atma, the knowledge also is like that. Is it clear this line? These are small bits, questions and answers. Kidrusham Atma Jnanam, Yadrushaha Atma, that is the answer. Whatever is that Atma, that type of knowledge. in accordance with what it is. So that is it. Kidruk saha.
Kidruk saha.
What type of what is that? Of what type is that atma? Then yadrushaha. Where is it? Yadrushaha Bhagavata Uktaha.
Yadrushaha Bhagavata Uktaha.
Upanishad Vakyascha Nyayatascha.
Upanishad Vakyascha Nyayatascha.
Okay, Kidrusha means what type of Atma is that? So that which has been told by the Lord, as has been told by Bhagavan, and also by the Upanishads, and also it is logically founded. It is reason by it is founded by reason, supported by reason. Nyayatascha. So number one is Bhagavan has told, Shruti has told, and also Nyaya, it is also logical. Then we are coming to a small discussion. This small bits and pieces, the answers is very clear, very simple. Then, Nanu Vishayakaram Jnanam.
Nanu Vishayakaram Jnanam.
Na Vishayaha Napi Akaravan Atma Ishyate Kvachit. So now here of course we can say it as a sort of Purvapaksha by some Purvapakshi, or the Siddhanti himself, in order to explain, he is posing a question to himself. Anyway, it doesn't matter much. The meaning is, the question is like this: Nanu Vishayakaram Jnanam. So in all types of ordinary Jnanam, we are now talking about the difference between the Atma Jnanam and Vishaya Jnanam. If you are talking about a jnanam of a pen, then we know that there is what is called, there are antahkaranam, trividham chaitanyam. Then one is antahkaranavachinam chaitanyam. Then one is vishayavachinam chaitanyam, the chaitanya which is associated with the object, chaitanya which is associated with the antahkarana, and chaitanya which is associated with this vritti, isn't it? Vrittiyavachinam chaitanyam. All these three things, they merge and then they get processed in this antahkarana. Then in that antahkarana, this vishaya jnanam takes place. So that is what we have seen. So vishayakaram jnanam. So that means when I say pen, the knowledge of a pen means my mind takes the shape of this particular object. So vishayakaram apnoti. My mind antahkaranam takes the shape of this particular object. But then atma is not like that. Atma is something, na vishayaha, it is not a vishaya, it is not an object. Napi akaravan atma, there is no shape. Akaravan, akarahasya sthiti akaravan. There is no akara, there is no shape for that atma. Akaravan atma ishyate kvachit, it is not mentioned anywhere. Ishyate means not admitted anywhere. Ishyate is admitted, not admitted anywhere by anybody. Kvachit, anywhere. It is not admitted anywhere by anybody. Atma is having some akara. Atma is of this type, red, green, blue, and it is of the size of a tree or something like that. It has not been told anywhere. Then, again, say here, Nanu.
Nanu.
Adityavarnam bhasvarupaha swayam jyotihi.
Adityavarnam bhasvarupaha swayam jyotihi.
Ityakaratvam atmanah shruyate. We can presume that this is a small explanation by a Dvaiti who does not want Atma to be Nirakara. So that is what here the sub-commentator says. Evam Atmanah Nirakaratvam Asahamanah. I am reading the sub-commentary of Bellamkonda Ramaraya Kavi. Evam Atmanah Nirakaratvam Asahamanah Dvaiti Chodayati Nanu Iti. So he is saying that these words can be explained as the words of a Dvaiti, a dualist who wants to say asahamanaha, nirakaratvam asahamanaha. He is unable to tolerate this nirakaratvam of atma. So he is not able to tolerate the concept that atma is something which is asanga, which is nirakara, nishkriya. He is unable to tolerate. So that is why he is posing this question. That is what he says. Nanu aditya varnam. So it is of the nature of that Aditya Varna, that is as brilliant as that Aditya. Because there is, you can't give a better example, because whatever you want to say, you have to take some example which we know. So it is something which has got the radiance of the sun, Aditya Varnam, as brilliance, the great luminosity of the sun. Then Bhaswarupam, Bha we know, Bha means light, knowledge, both light and knowledge. Bhaswarupam, it is of the nature of illumining things, basically illumining things, that is making in both ways, light and also enabling us to know. Bhaswarupam aswayam jyotihi, that is something which is self-luminous. There is nothing which is illumining it. तस्य भाषा सर्वमिदं विभाति बिकॉज ऑफ दैट थिंग एवरीथिंग एल्स इज नोन बिकॉज ऑफ दैट आत्मा एवरीथिंग एल्स इज नोन इट इज द नोवर इट इज द दृक् एंड नॉट दृश्यम ऑल दोज थिंग्स वी हैव सीन इति श्रूयते बट देन बट ऑल दिस थिंग श्रूयते यस ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर इन दिस देन ना तमो रूपत्व प्रतिषेधार्थत्वात् तेषां वाक्यानां सिद्धांति सेज ऑल दोस सेंटेंसेस आर मेंट टू तमो रूपत्व प्रतिषेधार्थम दैट इज इन ऑर्डर टू रिजेक्ट तमो रूपत्वम इज दैट इट इज समथिंग विच इज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ डार्कनेस वाई दैट स्टेज ऑफ डार्कनेस इज कमिंग ही इज गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन इन द नेक्स्ट लाइन बिकॉज you are negating or you are rejecting that it is not dravyam it is there is no guna there is no akara etc 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 when you deny or reject everything then what else is remaining some sort of darkness some sort of tamas is only is there some sort of ignorance so in order to reject that state of ignorance that type of darkness so these words are there aditya varnam bhaswarupam swayam jyotihi etc etc are there Not to say that Atma is having some shape or Atma is something which is visible. It is only to reject the contingency, reject the possibility that Atma can be misunderstood as something which is tamo rupam. Atma is something which can be misunderstood as something which is dark in nature. So that sort of thing. So tamo rupatva pratishedhartatvat tesham vakyanam. All those sentences. Are meant for that only. Why that tamo rupatva? He is explaining the next end line. Dravya guna adhyakara pratishedhe.
Dravya guna adhyakara pratishedhe.
Atmanaha tamo rupatve prapte.
Atmanaha tamo rupatve prapte. Tat pratishedhartani.
Adityavarnam ityadini vakyani. So these sentences, adityavarnam ityadini vakyani, adityavarnam bhaswarupam, swayam jyoti, etc., etc., all these sentences, why they are atmanaha tamorupatve prapte, in the contingency of this atma being a tamorupa, why that is arising? You come to the first point, dravya gunadhyakara pratishedhe. We have rejected dravyam. Atma is not dravyam, something which is a substance. Then guna, there is no question of guna in that. Then akara, there is no question of shape in that. All these things are pratishiddha. All the gunas are denied or rejected. When all these things are denied or rejected, then tamo rupatve prapte. So a contingency has arisen where one can misunderstand it as something which is of the nature of darkness, isn't it? Prapte. तत् प्रतिषेधार्थानि दैट इज इन ऑर्डर टू रिजेक्ट ऑल दैट आदित्यवर्णम इत्यादीनि वाक्यानि यू फॉलो देयर इज नथिंग इज इट नॉट वेरी डिफिकल्ट आई सपोज देन अरूपमिति च विशेषतः रूप प्रतिषेधात् अविषयत्वाच्च न संदृशे तिष्ठति रूपमस्य न चक्षुषा पश्यति कश्चनैनम् अशब्दम अस्पर्श्यम इत्याद्यैः तस्माद् आत्माकारं ज्ञानमित्यनुपपन्नम् व्हाट इज दिस व्हाट डज योर बुक से आत्मा ओके ज्ञानम इत्यनुपपन्नम ओके आत्मा आकारं ज्ञानमित्यनुपपन्नम ओके सो नाउ सम मोर सेंटेंसेस आर बीइंग कोटेड अरूपम इति च विशेषतः रूप प्रतिषेधात् Now, Atma does not have a rupam. How do you know? Arupam, asyabdam, asparsham, arupam, avyayam, visa, tatha, gandha, vachayate, etc., etc. We have seen those lines. Arupam is something which is formless. Iti visheshataha. Visheshataha means exclusively, specially, exclusively, by specific mention. Visheshataha means by specifically mentioning that rupa pratishedhat. Then avishayatvacha, it is also not an object. There can be an object which is unseen, something like James Bond car. It's not like that. So invisible car, something it is not like that. Na vena sandruse tishthati rupamasya. So this is an avishaya, it is not an object. Na sandruse means druk vishaye. it is not in the realm of seeing, it is not in the realm of sight, it is not in the purview of sight. So, na sandrushe tishthati rupamasya, it is not in the say purview of sight. That is, na chakshusha pasyati kashchanayanam, you can't see it, you can't physically see it by the sense organs. Chakshusha means upalakshanam for all other indriyas and mind. You cannot know it by indriyas and also by the mind. Then kashchanayanam. Then asabda, ashabdam, asparsham, rupam, avyayam, ityadyehi. It is neither sound nor sparsha. All these indriyas cannot go, the mind cannot go, etc. All these thing is from, one is from Kathopanishad, ashabdam, asparsham. Then nasandrushe tishthati rupamasya is from Shvetam Shvetashvatara Upanishad. So ityadyehi. Tasmad atmakaram jnanamita anupapannam. There is one jnanam which is of this atmakaram jnanam. So you see, vishayakaram jnanam, we have seen this word. Jnanam is vishayakaram. If I know this pen, this my jnanam of this is vishayam. My mind assumes the shape of this. But here it is not like that. Jnanam is not atmakaram. Atma has no akaram. Atma has no akaram, so I cannot say it is atmakaram jnanam. So that is it. Then what else? Katham tarhi atmanah jnanam. Then when you reject everything, then how is it you are going to explain what is this atma jnanam? You are saying that na atmakaram jnanam. So it is atmakaram jnanam iti anupapannam. You cannot say, it doesn't fit in. It is atmakaram jnanam, I know. Well, that means you are distancing yourself from this jnanam, and then you are saying, yes, I know this atma. You are separating yourself from this atma. Then who are you? So then this is something which is anupapannam. Then katham tarhi atmanah jnanam.
Katham tarhi atmanah jnanam.
Then what is meant by what exactly is this atma jnanam, and how is it that you are going to see? You see, all our say siddhanta, we don't say, if we see all this, we try to know what is the ultimate. The difference between Indian system and the Upanishad, the difference between the Upanishadic system and any religion, if you take, religion is basically a matter of belief, isn't it?
Yeah.
You see, my book says like this, my God is like this, my God did this, my God did that. It is all by virtue of belief. It is only belief, isn't it? It is only my book versus your book, isn't it? Whoever is strong, okay, we will fight it out. That is what is happening at the world level today. But then our approach is not to believe in say something ultimate, not to believe in Brahma, or not to believe in God, but to know God. But to know God, but to understand God, to know. Not a question of believing, but a question of knowing. So our approach is not to believe in God, but to know God. So you can say like that. Atma katham tarhi atmano jnanam. Then sarvam hi yadvishayam yadjnanam.
Sarvam hi yadvishayam yadjnanam.
Tattadakaram bhavati.
Tattadakaram bhavati.
The same thing which we saw. Sarvam hi yadvishayam yadjnanam. That is, whatever is the object in that jnana, whatever is the objective in that particular jnana, jnanam takes the shape of that particular object. Yadvishayam yat jnanam tat tadakaram bhavati. Tat means tat jnanam, tadakaram bhavati. So when I am seeing a pen, my mind or my jnanam takes the shape of that particular thing. So nirakarascha atma ityuktam.
Nirakarascha
atma. So this particular atma is something which is nirakara. It is nirguna, nirakara, and then asabda, sparsha, etc. You can't perceive by any sense or anything. Then jnanatmanascha. Jnanatmanoscha.
Jnanatmanoscha.
Ubhayoho nirakaratve.
Ubhayoho nirakaratve.
Katham tad bhavana nishtha.
Katham
tad
bhavana
nishtha.
Iti.
Okay, Purvapakshi's question is, jnana atmanoho, both jnanam and atma. Jnana atmanoho, of both jnanam and atma. This is Shashti Bahuvachanam, Shashti Dvivachanam. Jnana atmanoho, ubhayoho, of both, nirakaratve sati. When they are both nirakaram, jnanam also is nirakaram, atma is also nirakaram. Then where is the question of jnana nishtha? Where is the katham tad bhavana? Bhavana means anusandhanam. How is that anusandhanam? In Vedanta, this anusandhana is a very important thing. Every morning what we do is sandhyavandana. Sandhyavandana is a type of anusandhana. Anusandhana, you are every day you are saying bhargo devasya dhimahi diyo yuvana prachodayat, etc., etc. That is a sort of, that is anusandhana. Anusandhana, 3 times a day we are doing it for purifying our mind, isn't it? Otherwise, the mind is distracted, it runs here and there. Suppose you take bath in the morning. By evening again, there is a lot, body will be stinking. Suppose you don't take bath for 2-3 days, the body will be stinking more, isn't it? So, similarly, the mind also stinks. You have to do Sandhyavandana in order to purify your mind. Again some Sandhyavandana in the afternoon, again to purify the mind. Again some Sandhyavandana in the night, again to purify the mind, and then give your proper keep the proper coordinates in the mind. Proper coordinates means so and so pravaranvita, so and so adhyayi, etc., etc. You are directing your mind, fixing your mind in those coordinates, isn't it? So, like that, I said the mind has to be also purified. It is something like taking a bath only. Just as we take the bath, we also have to go through these spiritual exercises. So, anyway, nirakarasyatma yuktam jnanaatmanoho ubhayoho nirakaratve, that anusandhana. Yeah, I diverted from this word anusandhana. So, the word anusandhana is a constant realization, constant recapitulation of the teaching, and then trying to apply to yourself. Applying to oneself is that anusandhana. Applying to oneself, yes, I am that anusandhana is that, is that. And you will be able to apply to that only when the mind is sufficiently pure. If the mind is not sufficiently pure, then we know that we are trying to deceive ourselves. There is no question of anusandhana. So that is it. Katham tad bhavana nishtha iti na atyanta nirmalatvat. अत्यंत निर्मलत्व अति स्वच्छत्व अति सूक्ष्मत्वोपपत्तेः आत्मनः नैर्मल्याद्युपपत्तेः आत्मसम आत्मवत् नैर्मल्याद्युपपत्तेः आत्मचैतन्याकाराभासत्व उपपत्तिः ओके नाउ वी आर सीइंग गोइंग बैक टू व्हाट वेदांत परिभाषा सेज अबाउट माइंड. Vedanta Paribhashakara, what does he say? Dharmaraja Advari, he says, mind is that atyachya virala taijasa dravyam manaha, that is something which is very pure in nature. It is the product of all this sattva, the collective sattva of all these five tanmatras, isn't it? Of all the five tanmatras, the collective sattva from our sattva guna, from the collective sattva guna of all these things, the mind is born. So mind is able to see, mind is able to experience which is produced before us by all the five senses, isn't it? So mind is something which is of the nature of very, very fine, refined thing. Mind is again insentient. Mind is jada. Antahkaranam is jada. Buddhi vritti is jada. But it is such a fine jada padartha which is able to reflect that chaitanya, which is able to say avachedaka. Of course, Shankaracharya uses three different words in three different places. One is avachedaka. It can capture. Avacheda is something like capturing. That is like a ghata akasha captures a small portion of akasha. And then when the ghata is broken, it is akasha. There is no difference between ghata akasha and matakasha. Mahakasha. So similarly, it is something which captures. So antahkarana is something which captures that consciousness. That is avacheda. Then sometimes he uses the word pratibimba, atma chaitanya pratiphalanam, he says, something which is called pratiphalanam, it is something which is reflecting. Here of course he uses the word abhasa. Abhasa means semblance, resemblance. It is just resembling that atma chaitanya abhasa. This antahkarana is as though resembling that atma chaitanya. So he uses these three words. Because atma chaitanya can be depending on the context you have to explain to the student. Depending on the context, this Atma Chaitanya, what is the nature of this Chaitanya or consciousness, has to be explained to the student. So that is why at some places he uses the word Avacheda, like Ghatakasha, say Mahakasha, etc. Sometimes he uses the word Pratiphalanam, that is reflection. Then at times he uses the word Abhasa. So here he is using the word Abhasa. So here he says, अत्यंतया अत्यंत निर्मलत्वात् अति स्वच्छत्वात् बिकॉज इट इज समथिंग विच इज निर्मल अति स्वच्छ देन स्वच्छ इज प्योर निर्मल अगेन इज ऑल्सो अनदर वे ऑफ सेइंग प्योर अति सूक्ष्मत्व इट इज वेरी वेरी सटल सो उपपत्तेः आत्मनः दिस आत्मा is something like that. Atma of course it is just totally untouched by all these things. Buddhescha, even this buddhi also, of this buddhi also, Atma, you were saying Atma Samanairmalya. Atma Samanairmalya means it is almost equal. You should not say it is equal, we should say almost equal, because if it is equal then it becomes sentient again. Buddhi is insentient. Atmavat. So this is my probably this appears to be better reading. Atmavat nairmalyat, it is something like atma, it is something nairmalyam. Nairmalyadi upapattehe, nairmalyadi means nirmalatva, swachhatva, sushmatva, adi upapattehe. It is also having some of these qualities. Upapattesha chaitanyakara abhasatva upapattehi. So that chaitanyakara, that is resembling, it is appearing as though it is like chaitanya. It is resembling, it is appearing as though, or rather it is manifesting as though, or manifesting as a semblance of Chaitanya. You can write down like that, manifesting as a semblance of Chaitanya. So, Chaitanya kara abhasatva upapattihi. It is manifesting as a semblance of Chaitanya. Then he is logically proceeding, buddhyabhasam manaha, tadabhasiyan, tadabhasadini indriyani, indriyabhasascha dehaha. अतः लौकिकैः देहमात्र एव आत्मदृष्टिः क्रियते. सो बुद्ध्याभासं मनः. सो वी हैव कम टू वन हायर लेवल कॉल्ड बुद्धि आर अंतःकरणम्. देन वी लेट अस कम टू स्लाइटली अ लोअर लेवल कॉल्ड मनस. बुद्ध्याभासं मनः. व्हाटएवर इज बुद्धि दैट अंतःकरण दैट हाईली सेंसिटिव थिंग it is capturing, slightly it is coming down at the level of manas. Then mana abhasani indriyani, tad abhasadini indriyani. Indriyas, they capture some little bit of consciousness. It is, you see, antahkarana is the bigger receptacle. From that you imagine some layers. Antahkarana is a bigger receptacle or a stronger receptacle. And then if you have seen what is this, say, eclipse, there is what is called umbra, penumbra, etc., etc., you draw some lines. So something like that, you visualize something for parallel. So antahkarana is something which is having greater purity and which is able to capture that chaitanya. Then manas is at a slightly lower level. Indriya is much lower level because they can see only one thing. Then indriya bhasascha deha. Deha, the body also is appearing as though it is, say, having some chaitanyam. All that abhasa, this appearance, it is manifesting as though this mind also is chaitanya. Indriyas are appearing as though they are also, say, having chaitanyam. Deha also is manifesting as though it is having chaitanyam. So that is it. Chaitanya bhasa is seen right down to deha. That is in a decreasing order. First at buddhi level. Next at manas level, next at indriya level, next at body level, in a decreasing order, some amount of chaitanya or consciousness is seen in a decreasing order. So that is it. Then that is why, ataha, laukikaihi. Laukikaihi means by all ignorant people. Laukika means here, pamaraihi, by ignorant people. Dehamatra eva atmadrushti kriyate. Dehamatra eva atmadrushti kriyate. That is, like the Charvakas, who say that body is nothing but body. This Atma is something but what is there in the body. The whole Chaitanya is something which is born in the body. So that is what they say. We will continue in the next class. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.